The King James, old King James translation says, all men seek thee. Jesus had isolated himself in a place of prayer. He decided to take off some time in a place of prayer. And everyone had heard about the miracles that he performed. Everyone had heard about the healings that he had done. But even when he had isolated himself in a place of prayer, the Bible says that the disciples went, when they found him, they said, Master, all men seek thee. Prayer makes you magnetic to things and to people. The things that you desire, they are looking for you. But they will find you in a place of prayer. It is prayer that causes people to grow. There are levels in prayer where all the things that you're seeking for, all the things that you desire, will begin to look for you. The people that will bless you, the people that will take you to the next level, the people that have to open doors for you, they are only called in the place of prayer. Praise the Lord. Instead of seeking for things, instead of looking for people, let us take time, more time in the place of prayer. These things will be added unto us. The Bible says, seek ye first the kingdom of God. Seek ye first the kingdom of God. The Bible says, ask and you shall receive. Knock and the door will open. Seek and you shall find. When did Jesus say these things? Jesus spoke about these things when he was teaching his disciples about prayer. He taught them how to pray. Then he continued to say, ask and it shall be given to you. Knock and the door shall open. Seek and you shall find. If we take it a little bit deeper, all these are levels of prayer. Yes. Praise the Lord. The Lord is calling us to a place of prayer more than we have ever been before. He's calling us to pray more than we prayed before. And it is for a place of prayer that all these things shall be attracted to us. These things shall be drawn to us. Somebody say hallelujah. Prayer causes growth and transformation. The Bible documents that Enoch walked with God and he was not for God to kill. We all know the story of Enoch. Enoch developed intimacy, fellowship. He spent more time with God. The Bible says he walked with God. He walked with God until he was no more. God took him. God took him. There is a place that God is drawing us to. There is a place that God is calling us to. Brothers and sisters, God is calling us deeper in prayer, deeper in fellowship with him. What is the objective of my sharing? Number one, to understand the role of the Holy Spirit in prayer. Amen. To understand the role of the Holy Spirit in prayer. Number two, the role of praying in tongues. Number three, to understand human limitations in the journey of prayer. To understand human limitations in the place of prayer. Number four, lastly, to understand when and where effective prayer begins. When and where effective prayer begins. There is a place in prayer where effective prayer begins. The Bible says the effectual fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. The question is, what is effective prayer? And when does effective prayer begin? Effective prayer begins when the Holy Spirit comes and bears witness with your weaknesses and then takes over the prayer, so that you pray not in your own understanding. You pray not limited in your human limitations, but you pray by the leading of the Holy Spirit. Tell your neighbor, He is the boss in prayer.
He is the boss in prayer.
The Holy Spirit is the boss in prayer. Let's turn our Bibles to the book of Romans chapter 8 from verse 26. Romans chapter 8 from verse 26. And we shall read 26 and 27. The Bible says, likewise, the Spirit also helps in our weakness. Someone say in our weakness.
In our weakness.
The Holy Spirit helps in our weaknesses. Our weaknesses in the place of prayer. For we do not know what we should pray for as we ought. But the Spirit Himself makes intercession for us. Someone say for us.
For us.
Someone say for me.
For me.
But the Holy Spirit Himself makes intercession for us. In other words, there is a place of prayer where it is not you that prays, but it is the Holy Spirit.
Wait.
I would like one thing to emphasize that. There is a place in prayer where it is not you that prays, but it is the Holy Spirit that prays. And that is the beginning of effective prayer. The place where it is not you that prays, but it is the Holy Spirit that prays. Say once again, He prays for me.
He prays for me.
The Bible says, with groanings which cannot be uttered. There is a place of prayer where groanings that cannot be uttered take over. You have no control of what you say. All you do is to just release a sound. Now He who searches the hearts knows what the mind of the Spirit is. The Holy Spirit searches our hearts in a place of prayer, that we may be able to pray according to the will of God.
Amen.
Tell your neighbor, the Holy Spirit knows my needs.
The Holy Spirit knows my needs.
Because He makes intercession for the saints according to the will of God. Effective prayer or effectual prayer is praying according to the will of God. You and I may not know the will of God, but the Holy Spirit knows the will of God. That means that when the Holy Spirit takes over our prayer, then He will pray in us according to the will of God. He knows all our needs. He knows all that we desire. He knows the will of God. I will read in the Passion Translation. It breaks up this word and it makes it more contemporary so that you may have better understanding. The Passion Translation, which is TT. If you have a smartphone, it's TT Translation. It says, in a similar way, the Holy Spirit takes hold of us.
Amen.
Say, the Holy Spirit takes hold of me. The Holy Spirit wants to take hold of us. He wants to hold our hands. He wants to lead us. He wants to guide us.
Amen.
Similarly, the Holy Spirit takes hold of us in our human frailty. As humans, we are frail. We are weak. No wonder when you go to pray, many times you find yourself yawning. You find yourself struggling. You find yourself struggling. thing and you wonder when you are about to stop. Praise the Lord. But the Holy Spirit understands our weaknesses. He understands our human frailty to empower us in our weaknesses. It is the Holy Spirit that empowers us to pray. For example, at the time we don't even know how to pray, or know the best thing to ask. Do you know, according to the Bible here, many times we don't even know the best thing to ask? Tell your neighbor, surrender to the Holy Spirit. Allow the Holy Spirit to pray through you. Allow the Holy Spirit to intercede through you. Because we do not even know the best thing to ask. I'm painting a picture of limitations in our prayer from our mind and our imagination. There is a place to pray in the understanding, but there is a better place of prayer, and that is praying in the Spirit. Praise the Lord. I already see this place too small. I see this place being flooded by people. Hallelujah. The Bible continues to say, but the Holy Spirit rises up within us. Intercede. I will say that again. The Holy Spirit rises up within us. The Bible says that out of your belly shall flow. Out of your belly shall flow. Out of your belly shall flow rivers of life-giving water. The Bible says, but the Holy Spirit rises up within us. How many people want the Holy Spirit to rise up within us to super intercede? To super intercede. That quality is only meant for the Holy Spirit to super intercede through us. In other words, His level of intercession is beyond that which you're capable of doing in your human limitations. Praise the Lord. To super intercede on our behalf, pleading to God with emotional sighs too deep for words. The Holy Spirit pleads, super intercede on our behalf, pleading with God. It is the Holy Spirit who can perfectly plead with God on our behalf. The Bible says, in sighs that are too deep. Has anyone ever reach a place of prayer when words are not enough to express that which you want to come out of you? That is the place of effective prayer. That is the level of prayer that we must reach to. That is the place of prayer where we pray according to the will of God. That is a place where the Holy Spirit has taken over. That is the place where your prayer is perfect. That is the place where your prayer is in line with the will of God. With sighs too deep. With sighs too deep for words to express. Brothers and sisters, there is a place for praying in understanding. There is also a place to pray in tongues. But there is a place whereby words cannot express that want to come out of you. Signs that are too deep. That is the place and the moment where you pray according to the will of God. How many people want to desire to enter that level? It is the place where the perfect will of God is. It's the place whereby the best request that can ever come out of you is birth. Brothers and sisters, if you want to ask me where effective prayer begins at the place where the Holy Spirit is able to pray through you and create sighs that are too deep for words to express.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
before God for us. His Holy One in perfect harmony with God's plan and our destiny. God's plan and our destiny.
Amen.
You do not even know the best plan for you. When this year began, I never knew that I would be in Ololo in the month of October. I had my plans written out. As a matter of fact, because I have been to school, I have my 5 years strategic master plan. But as I walk with the Holy Spirit, I discover that all those plans have been circumgated. I keep them in my computer. I know that God is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us. I believe that one time God will meet my plan and He will supersede my plan. The things that you think will come in the next 5 years, God can do them in 3 months. Hallelujah. So it is the Holy Spirit that works in perfect harmony with God's plan and our destiny. No one knows your destiny more than the Holy Spirit. A man's heart is full of plans, but it is God who causes each of them to prosper. Tell your neighbor, ask the Holy Spirit to rearrange your plans. So from the text that we have looked at, number one, we have human limitations in prayer. That is a fact. We have human limitations in prayer. If you understand that, it is a lot easier to depend on the person of the Holy Spirit. It is a lot easier for you to surrender your heart so that you can depend on the Holy Spirit. Number two, we did not know what and how to pray. Number one, we have human limitations. Number two, we do not know what and how to pray. Theologians say that the temple of the Lord is divided in three parts. There is number one, the outer court. Number two, there is the inner court. Then thirdly, there is the Holy of Holies. Many times our prayer is in the outer court. Those prayers of complaining. Those prayers of going to God with Jesus. Those prayers of painting the picture of the scenario. Those ones happen in the outer court. There are prayers that begin in the inner court, and there are prayers that take you to the holy world. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. Hallelujah.
So number three, the Holy Spirit prays in us according to the will of God. The Bible says this is the confidence that we have, that when we ask anything, He will hear us.
Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. I'd like to close this so that we can have some time to pray. Let's go to the book of 1 Kings, chapter 18. Verse 41. 1 Kings chapter 18, verse 41 and 42. Why don't you just take a minute and pray in the Holy Ghost? Marisha, da 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 Then
Corinthians chapter 15, verse 15, verse 15.
And these are common scriptures. Common scriptures among believers. Verse 2 says, for he who speaks in tongues does not speak to men, but to God. For no one understands him. However, in the spirit he speaks mysteries. He does not speak to men, but he speaks to God. For no one understands you, however, in the spirit he speaks mysteries. When you are praying in tongues, you speak mysteries. Other translation says that your mind of no effect. Verse 4 says, he who speaks in tongues edifies himself. When you speak in tongues, you edify yourself. What does it mean to edify? To edify is to improve. Hallelujah. So when you're speaking in tongues, you're actually improving yourself.
Hallelujah.
He who speaks in tongues edifies himself. But he who prophesies edifies the church. Listen to what verse 14 says. For if I pray in tongues, my spirit prays. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When you pray in tongues, your spirit prays. And your spirit is capable of praying according to the will of God.
Amen.
The Bible says, if I pray in tongues, my spirit prays, but my understanding is unfruitful. That's why many times, even when you're praying in tongues and you're getting a little bit wary, you wonder whether these things make any sense. But they do make sense because you're speaking to God and it is your spirit that is praying. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And verse 15, 1 Corinthians chapter 14, verse 15, the Bible says, what is the conclusion then? I will pray with the Spirit, and I will also pray with understanding. I will sing with the Spirit, and I will also sing with understanding. Whenever we come like this, we must have the liberty to choose any mode of prayer. To pray in understanding, pray in the spirit, to sing in the spirit, and to also sing in understanding. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Jude 1:20. Someone may be asking, what is this thing this guy is doing? Why do they dwell so much at the altar? Why do they dwell so much in speaking in tongues? So they have better things to do. But this is what Jude says. There's only one chapter in Jude. Verse 20 says, but you, beloved, build yourself up. Tell your neighbor, build yourself up.
Build yourself up.
Build yourself up in your most holy faith, pray in the Holy Spirit. You build up yourself. You build up in your faith, pray in the Holy Spirit. There is what they call stamina in the walk of faith. Have you ever had a dream where you are about to get your breakthrough and then you have no energy to walk anymore and you collapse before you reach the destination? It means your spirit is weak. The only way you can build stamina to be able to take hold and lay hold of your blessing is by praying in the Holy Ghost. How many people are enjoying it? Let me wrap up quickly. There are five benefits, among other benefits, of praying in the Spirit. Benefit number one is an edification. Edification simply means improving yourself. That's why prayer causes growth and transformation. As a Christian, other than the Word of God, the other way to edify yourself is by praying in the Spirit. Number two, the benefit of praying in the Spirit, it strengthens you. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. But that statement is very relative, depending on who it is. They that know their God shall be strong, and they shall do mighty exploits. The Bible says, have you heard that God, He is not worthy, He gives strength to the faint. They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They will walk and not be weary. They will run and not faint. But there is the third level, they are able to mount up with wings. They are able to mount up with wings and soar like eagles. That strength is gained when you pray in the Spirit. Number three, the benefit of praying in the Spirit is to gain ascendancy. It is to gain ascendancy in the realm of the Spirit, to position yourself in the right place. What is the right place? Where you're seated with Christ Jesus, Ephesians chapter 2. Far above principalities, powers, and rulers of God in darkness. Positions are not the same in the realm of the Spirit for every Christian. Yes, it is a promise that we are seated with Christ Jesus, but you gain ascendancy in praying in the Spirit. That's when you gain position in the realm of the Spirit. Hallelujah. Number four, praying in the Spirit, you gain clarity of the voice of God. Some people, and among us, we have got many of them. God has graced them in a very special way. They have visions. They are able to see visions. They are able to see visions. They just see visions. They see angels all around us. But some of us may not be graced. But one of the ways for me, what works for me is that when I pray for long in the Spirit, I begin to have certain things quickened in my spirit. And that's how I get clarity of the voice of God. Praise the Lord. Is someone doing this? And lastly, prayer is the only thing that accelerates and enhances spiritual growth. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's start to our feet, everyone.